BMTW Championship. Dave Bradshaw here alongside former British heavyweight champion Alex Shane. And Alex, you've been sitting ringside for all of what's been going on in NGW over the past year. What's your take on who the favourite is tonight?
Well, you know, as someone who's been in the professional wrestling business in Great Britain for over 20 years, I've been around all sorts of hype. I've been around all sorts of exaggeration. But when NGW called this match the ultimate showdown, it really, really is going to live up to that kind of billing. Because broadcast in over 35 countries around the world, and we're three of the best professional wrestlers that the United Kingdom has produced in my lifetime, and for the unified NGW heavyweight titles, Dave, this one is going to be big.
Absolutely, three incredible athletes, and this one is undoubtedly the scariest of them all. He called him the Controls Unstoppable Monster, and he is exactly that, the first ever undisputed champion here in NGW, Rampage Brown.
And let's not forget, he's coming to the ring with the managing director of New Generation Wrestling, Richie West, who is the businessman who is taking this company global, but at the same time is a devious, devious individual to have in your corner.
This crowd here in Hull, absolutely not Rampage Brown fans, as you can hear.
Well, what will be really interesting is we know for a fact that they'll be on the side of the champion, but a man whose popularity has been on the rise for some time in British wrestling is Zach Gibson. When he walks into the Liverpool Olympia, this guy is like the second coming of Big Daddy. What reception will he receive in the whole City Hall? Well, we're just moments away, Dave, from finding out.
Unlikely to ever meet a more intense young man than Liverpool's number one, the winner of the Davey Boy Smith Cup, Zach Gibson. Alex, what do you think Zach's chances are here against Rampage and Nathan, two men he knows so very, very well?
I've said it before on this program, and I will say it again. In my opinion, Zach Gibson may just be the best pound-for-pound technician in European wrestling today.
A no-nonsense fighter from Merseyside. Not just any fighter, a very, very successful one. He's had high-profile matches with both of his opponents tonight, and he's gone toe-to-toe successfully with them both. Will it be his night tonight? Will he finally win the big one, the undisputed NGW Championship?
And I don't know if you noticed, Dave, there were some fans here at ringside who were reaching out to clap the hand of the challenger, and Gibson reciprocated that attention. Is that a sign of what's to come for Nathan Cruz? What kind of reaction is he going to get? Because let's not forget, the last time he was here, it was against his best friend, Matt Myers, and Cruz began to get some boots. What's going to happen? Very, very interesting.
So, Gibson in the ring, Rampage Brown in the ring, and we await the arrival of the man who has been champion for a year.
Well, here we go. Oh, Dave, can you hear that?
Audible boos here, almost a less favourable reception, as you say, Alex, than Zach Gibson received, and that will get into the head of the champion in his hometown, you've got to think.
Well, there's many things you can say about Nathan Cruz, but I'm going to go on record right now, Dave, as saying that there is no champion in the history of British wrestling who has been better and more dependable in defending his title on television than that man right there. You know, Nathan Cruz was on the first ever wrestling contest that was broadcast nationally in the United Kingdom in over a quarter of a century. And now he takes part in the first ever British heavyweight showdown to be broadcast globally.
He certainly looks ready, doesn't he? And as you say, he has faced all comers in the past year, whether they're crowd favourites or villains. And as Nathan Cruz might say, if you want to make an omelette, you've got to break a few eggs. Maybe he doesn't mind if he's lost the support of a few fans, if it means he's kept the title for a full year.
And that's the thing, you know, Nathan Cruz has taken on friend and foe alike. And some of those friends, like Matt Myers, particularly in this building, are extremely popular. But now he goes in there with a man who is hated in Rampage Brown, the former champion, and a man who is on the rise in Zach Gibson. talk about the ultimate showdown, Dave, this really, really is it for British wrestling.
Of course, the ultimate irony here for Nathan Cruz after this historic title reign is under the rules of this match, he could lose the championship tonight without even being pinned. Championship glory.
They are opponents, David. Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Well, Rampage trying to take them both out. Dropkick by Cruz takes the big man down. And there you do see, briefly, Gibson and Cruz were on the same page.
And Dave, I've been waiting for this one. Cruz and Gibson, you know, their third showdown was supposed to be the decider. But due to the interference of the control, Nathan Cruz won with a chair shot to Gibson. And it was a very bad victory in many people's opinions. And now these two are finally going to get a chance to get head on again.
Well, if you're going to get into a slugfest with Zach Gibson, I don't even know if Nathan Cruz can win there. Rampage back in now as the champion blocks him. Well, I think Cruz was aiming for Brown, but in the end he hit Gibson and Rampage goes for the clothesline, a high knee from the champion.
And Cruz showing why he has been an unstoppable force in his own right for the last year on this programme.
So I'm not sure Cruz intended to hit Gibson, but I don't think he'll care. Both men, of course, as enemies in this one tonight. With that high knee again, back live now.
Oh, look at the strength there, Nathan Cruz. Cruz, Dave, is the smallest man in this match, but with the power he's displaying there, it really, really isn't a disadvantage.
The stamina and tenacity of Cruz, though, is unmatched by anyone.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Gibson with a dive onto Rampage Brown.
That's exactly what happened when they were a tag team, but whoa!
Well, that didn't happen.
Wow.
Well, Cruz obviously remembering that move by Gibson from that tag team match, and this time Cruz was ready to jump on Gibson afterwards.
Well, Gibson's ego got the best of him there, as did his pride, and now these two on the outside, what's going on here?
Oh! Oh my God, what impact.
It was like a gun going off in the whole city hall.
Echoed around the building, did that, as Cruz getting back on the correct side of those steel barriers.
And Gibson looks knocked for six on that one. His eyes were glazed over, and we're only just waiting game.
Well, we're going to have to take a commercial break here in a second. Oh, my goodness. Rampage sweeping the feet away of Nathan Cruz. And what's this? Hang on.
Hold up.
Oh, my God. Look at that. Into the ring apron. We'll be back in just a moment. Back here on British Wrestling Weekly, the champion Nathan Cruz is still down after that brutal powerbomb onto the ring apron by Rampage Brown, and Brown now is brawling on the outside with Zach Gibson, Alex.
Ah, and Dave, the way Nathan Cruz landed, it was literally on his spinal cord, in between the vertebrae, on the corner of that ring. It did not look good, and it could be a real, real game changer.
Well, at least for the meantime, Nathan Cruz is completely out of this one, and that is allowing Rampage Brown to use that power and to assert his dominance in this championship match.
And what power it is. And if you see this replay here, Dave, look at Cruz's spine. Oh, I could end a man's career, and I'm not exaggerating when I say that.
Talk about the power of Rampage Brown. Well, the way he became co-number one contender here was in a four-man tournament in the semi-finals of that. He beat the heavyweight House of Pain, Styx, who is no slouch himself.
He's one half of the NGW Tag Team Champions, but let's not forget who Zach Gibson beat to get to the finals. It was the man that WWE.com called the best wrestler on the planet today, not signed to that company, Zack Sabre Jr. So both of these men had a tough, tough road to the finals, but a finals that ended in a double disqualification.
Nothing can separate these two men. That's why this is a triple threat match, a three corners match, rather than a one-on-one.
And both of these guys were hoping that they would come out of this year's NGW 20-man Destiny Rumble as the number one contender. Remember, every year the winner gets a shot at the title. But these two men ultimately cancelled out each other's chances. And Dave, you've got to believe that Doug Williams, star of TNA, Ring of Honor, Noah in Japan, former British heavyweight champion himself, is going to be backstage watching this one on the monitor.
Right, yeah, he's the wild card in this whole championship situation. Whoever wins tonight is going to have to face Doug Williams sometime down the road. While we've been talking, Alex, you've got to say, Rampage Brown has had the better of Zach Gibson from start to finish in the last couple of minutes.
And I'll tell you what else has happened. I've been hearing chants of let's go Cruz, let's go Gibson. There is definitely a contingent of this audience in the whole City Hall that is for Zach Gibson. I would argue that the children, the mums, and even some of the older crowd like Nathan Cruz, the champion, but the older audience like Gibson. And look at this slow motion.
Oh. You see again, that's the powerbomb from before the break, and that's why Nathan Cruz is a non-entity in this contest at the moment and has been for several minutes.
Super slow motion, but I'm not so sure I liked it. Like I said earlier, that ring is made of wood and metal, and that went directly between the vertebrae of the champion.
Ring apron, of course, the hardest part of the ring as well, as finally Gibson able to counter. This is his chance to get back into this against Rampage.
And the other thing we should mention, signed earlier this week, the Team Warfare match. Team NGW against Team Control. Richie West, the managing director of NGW and the head of the Control, is going to try and take it all, Dave.
Gibson, though, meanwhile, is mounting some momentum here as he plants Rampage face first. Gibson, it looks like, is drawing energy from the cheers of the crowd. We've never seen that before.
And I'll tell you what else I haven't seen before. Look at the way the Control's unstoppable monster is being manhandled. Oh.
Just tossed over the head of Gibson as if he was a rag doll.
And Nathan Cruz, the fact we've not seen him move is a telltale sign to me. But I'll tell you what else, Rampage Brown, when was the last time you've split? He's clinging to the bottom rope, though.
Part of that may be ring smarts. You've got to think he's trying to save some energy there by not kicking out when he can reach the rope. But hang on, Gibson is going for those Shankly gates.
And look at Rampage trying to fly out of it all he can. And is he going to hit the Rampage driver, Falcon Arrow? And this could be all. Dave, this could be all.
Come on. New champion. And finally, just at the most opportune moment possible, Nathan Cruz saves his title.
God, the champion literally came from out of nowhere.
Slammed down onto his face again is Rampage, and Cruz himself has found a second win, just as Gibson did a minute ago.
Slingshot belly to back, vintage show stealer, and he's on fire here at the whole City Hall for your main event on British Wrestling Weekly's most televised global episode ever.
Cruz is going, he's got him on his back, he's got Rampage on his back, but I wonder if that lower back maybe gave out some residual effects of that powerbomb on the apron, and now Gibson again going for the Shankly gates.
He is relentless in going for the Shankly gates there, and Cruz making a good move to get out of that.
players, and Gibson had it scouted, got out of the way.
Right, and he went for that Merseyside drop. Did Nathan Cruz, and oh, show stolen. Fireman's carry, Michinoko driver.
And again, Gibson has it scouted. The action coming thick and fast here in Hull City Hall. And oh, collision there between Cruz and Gibson.
Dave, that's one of his finishing moves. Samoan drop.
Well, Brown has won matches with this before. And then, oh, nearly. We were, what, half a second, less than that away from Brown regaining the championship.
Well, that Samoan drop, Dave, that you see on our replay, and the pile driver is the finishing move of Rampage Brown. Of course, Nathan Cruz will be trying to hit the show stolen, that fireman's carry, Michinoko driver. And we all know now that Zach Gibson will be going for the Shankly Gates.
But of all three of them, the only one who successfully hit his signature move there was Rampage Brown. Is that an omen for how this is
going
to go?
Dave, he's going for that pole driver. The real killer is the move that put Nathan Cruz out for a year. Oh, Texas Cloverleaf.
Going for it again. He went for it against Gibson a minute ago. God, the strength it takes to get a man like Rampage Brown over, and he's done it. He's done it. Will Rampage have to tap?
And this is how he beat Lionheart, the head of Team Scotland. And look at... Oh my God, Richie West, yeah. Rampage Brown is a long way from those ropes, Dave.
Rampage Brown is almost having to tap. Even a man as tough as Rampage would have to. And oh, I think Gibson stopped him. Gibson saw the tap was coming and saved the match.
Wow. Talk about smart. Gibson knows where he is at all times. And now it's come down to the war to settle the score between Gibson and Cruz.
Cruz with those forearms to the face. And now, here comes Brown. Oh, God, he always took Nathan Cruz's head off. Cruz may be concussed.
He's called the controls Unstoppable Monster for a reason. Wow, Cruz is out. And what's Richie West?
What's West doing? Ridiculous. Enziguri by Gibson, meanwhile.
He's on the second day. Merseyside drop from the second.
Oh, that's got to do it.
Oh, that's got to do it. Richie West hasn't seen it, Dave. Richie West hasn't seen it.
Got the cover. Did West see it and let Cruz go? I'm not sure, but in any event, finally Cruz was able to break that up. That was certainly Gibson's moment if Cruz hadn't made the save.
And if you're watching British wrestling for the first time around the world, then what a match for you to see, because the most important televised title in the history of the business in this country is on the line.
Merseyside drop again. Cruz must be on his last ounces of energy now.
And Dave Gibson, look at this, and listen to this.
He's saying the end is nigh for Nathan Cruz's year-long championship reign.
It is getting hot, and I mean hot, in the whole City Hall, Dave, and listen to this crowd.
Gibson never shows if he's nervous, never shows anything but pure determination, but it's got to be in his mind somewhere now that he could be moments away from the biggest win of his career.
And Cruz looks out. But if there's one thing we've learned about Nathan Cruz, is that you cannot count this man out. Every time we have written him off and we have said that the belt is about to change hands, Cruz has dug that. Whoa.
Well, Rampage is back. Rampage back in this one. Takes out Gibson, but Cruz in a very vulnerable position.
And a chop from Rampage Brown is like a clothesline from another opponent. This guy is vicious.
What's he going to do here? As we said, Cruz can't have much left. Rampage with evil intentions.
This does not look good for the champ. No.
Dave,
he's
going
for that Samoan drop.
Not the Samoan drop.
No way.
Surely.
No way.
But Gibson's behind. Oh, hang on a minute. Zach Gibson. Oh, my God. No. No way.
Oh, my.
Oh! Got a powerbomb assisted Samoan drop. And the champion was the one who got the worst of it.
And look at this on our replay. What's going on in the ring? Hey!
Hang on. What? Gibson's got them both up. No way. He's not gonna.
Oh my God. He said it earlier. He called it. He said if he had to put both men in the Shankly Gates at the same time, he was gonna do it. And he is a man of his word, Dave. Look at
That's
this.
Unbelievable. And all it would take is for one of them to tap. Well, Rampage has escaped, but Cruz hasn't. Cruz is to his feet. And Cruz gets behind. Oh, good God. Gibson, a man of his word. Them in the Shankly Gates.
Oh, and Rampage down hard to the outside. And now it's Gibson. What's Gibson got?
A pinning combination, maybe. What's this?
Oh, How good?
How good?
Well, it's Liverpool's number one, Zach Gibson, Dave. Look at this. Shankly Gates.
Yeah, he's got into position there. And again, trying to get those Shankly Gates applied, but he sees Rampage coming and wisely tries to dispatch him. Cruzo. That gave Cruzo a chance
to come
back.
No way. Show stolen by the champion. Centre of the ring, Dave. Aggressive position.
The champion's going to retain the champion. Richie West. Damn it, just save the championship.
Oh, it's the rest of the control. It's Mark Haskins and the Proven.
Cruz season. We'll be right back here on British Wrestling Weekly, and the controller out here brewing with Cruz. But hang on. Here comes, there's Matt Myers, Liam Slater's out here. Sticks and Colossus.
NCW Tag Team Champions, and this is bedlam. Absolute bedlam. And referee Steve Linsky is going to have a tough job, because this is the ultimate showdown in British wrestling. But at some point, Dave, he's going to have to make a decision. This is broken down. We knew that the eight-man Team Warfare match had been signed, and some of the men that are going to take part in that are now brawling around the ring. And look at this.
Well, now some more members of the NGW crew coming down to try and further calm this down. As you say, Steve Linsky, he's been in the industry, over a quarter of a century. He's going to try and let this flow as much as he can, but there's a limit.
Well, the crew are trying to break this up, but we've seen, look at Cruz, Dave. We've seen Nathan Cruz take massive risks before. He told me he was working on a moonsault. And are we going to see that to the outside? Because it looks like he's up and...
And there's Gibson. Gibson's up there. Well, Cruz, surely that would have been a mistake, because he could be jeopardising his chances in the match. Three now. Rampage is safely back in here.
No way.
Well, Cruz is moving, but he's got seven already.
Oh, is Nathan going to get in? Cruz is going. Oh, Gibson!
Gibson grabbed the leg of Cruz! Gibson grabbed the leg of Cruz!
Rampage Brown has won the Ultimate Showdown by count out, and Nathan Cruz is fuming, as am I, Dave. A count out for the Ultimate Showdown. Can you believe it?
Well, of course, you know what that means. Well, Richie West is handing the championship belt to Rampage Brown. But as Linsky is quite rightly saying, titles can't change hands on a countout.